to some content using a couple different tools. And these tools are specifically applicable to EDU 218 kids as you're working on your Google Classroom assignment, but they're also really important and viable for EDU 360 kids. You might not use them for any of the assignments you complete in my particular class this semester, but they could be used in other classes. They'll certainly be handy as you move into your preclinical practice and you're thinking about planning your own lessons. So I want to talk a little bit about an idea and an activity that I had for creating timelines and sequencing activities. So we're going to look at using an online tool that's free to use. You sign up for free. Of course, like all those tools, there's enhanced features that you can choose to purchase. It gives you some limited tool set options if you use the free version. I'm going to show you the free version, though, and show you some of the things you can do and things that might come in helpful for you as you're planning lessons. So the first thing I'm going to do is show you what this tool is. It's called Sutori. It's a timelining tool. I was able to sign up for free with my Gmail account, and it allowed me to create that account and personalize it a little bit and then create these different stories. So in EDU 218, you might remember this was one of the storytelling tool options that we looked at. Now, I want to talk a little bit about my view of history and how I kind of put items in order based on when they happen and how I look back at my past. And you have to understand that I'm a your age person of the 90s, so I look at things in terms of Jordans. So my Sutori, my timeline, my story is told in terms of Jordans, as well as some other notable things.
Question.
Yes.
Who came second?
Who came in second?
Who came in second?
It was Alyssa K.
Alyssa K came third. Taylor came first.
Brit, I don't know. You'll have to check the chat. They'll tell you if they're wrong or right. You interrupted my important educational content, buddy. I love you. All right. So here's my Sutori. This is my story. It's going to be a timelining tool. It allows you to easily create, and then it lets you present and share as well. So I'm in create mode right now. I went into my OG intros, all of those songs I've been sharing with you, and I put them into this timeline. And then I went back in and I kind of supplemented things. So what you can see over here is that there's a little pop-up menu. I've put in main headings, and those headings are decades. When have things in our history, what are important cultural pieces of our history that you might remember or you at least have heard about, and they're in the side. But as we scroll down, you can see these are ordered on a timeline. I'm going to just kind of scroll through them. My first Jordan comes in 1985. That was the Air Jordan 1 called Notorious. Before that, though, what happened was something you might be familiar with was Charles and Diana's royal wedding. That was clear back in 81. And as I scroll through here, I've added like these important moments kind of in history throughout the 70s, 80s, and 90s, just for this example. I put all the shoes on there. I put in, you can see I've been able to embed YouTube links in here. So this is the Mars Blackman Spike Lee commercial with Air Jordan. This is when Tyson became undisputed heavyweight champ of the world by knocking out Michael Spinks in 91 seconds. A brutal, brutal beatdown. You guys should watch that clip.
That should be the OG movie.
Maybe that will be the OG sporting event.
Yeah.
Beastie Boys, which we had before. We move into the 90s with Desert Storm. Some of the Bulls Dynasty, one of my all-time favorite artists. Tupac and every single one of his albums is listed in here. We get further down. I think you get the point. Eventually, we're going to get to the 2000s. Things like 9/11's in there, Hurricane Katrina, the first iPhone. You guys are probably familiar with these things now that we're getting into the 2000s. Osama bin Laden's taken down. Tupac appears as a
concert.
Let's watch it, Aiden. What do you think?
Full screen on that thing. That thing
was
so
inappropriate. Came out in Coachella. As a hologram. Says, what's up, Gucci?
That's my choice.
Yeah! You know what the fuck this is? What up, Trey? What's up, punk? What up, Snoop? What's up, my nigga? What the fuck is up, Coachella? Yeah.
Anyways, so you get the idea here. We're embedding media, we're finding pictures, we're using text to create our own custom timelines. So how can this really be put into real use? Where is it going to be useful in the classroom? Sure, I can put up my Tupac videos and my Air Jordans and be entertaining and all that, but there really is a way that you can organize this. And what I've done is I've created a couple different Google spreadsheets. I didn't use Docs, I used Sheets. All right, Sheets I find are better in some cases because they're easier to for you to manipulate, and they already have the structure of rows and columns. You could certainly do this in a Google Doc, but you wouldn't see all of the features that you do by using Sheets. So this example here is an American Revolution example. I found a piece of text, which I linked over here for students to be able to open up and read. It's about the causes of the American Revolution, and it's on the history.com website. So I've included that text because I hope that students will go through and read this. And I hopefully before this have gone through and made sure that the reading level is appropriate for the age of students that I'm working with. But I always like to link that onto my graphic organizer. I've also included a set of clear and simple directions, so we know that this is an important piece of every assignment or piece of work you ask students to do, especially now when we're in COVID-19 mode and everything is online. All right, so you have to include clear directions for students so they know what to do. I ask them to review the events that are listed below in the events column and research those events using either their textbook or the text or sources that I provide in the Google Classroom or in the online space. Once they do that, they need to come into the graphic organizer and insert the year that each event took place in the year column, which is right in here, and then write a brief summary. And depending on the age of student you're working with, the summaries could be shorter or longer. You're going to have to make that call, where you tell the teacher more about what these things are. So this is a research portion. It's a thing to organize the work for them and to make sure that it's easy for them to read something and then respond back to it in a pretty straightforward manner. One thing that I've done in these examples, and I'll give you the links to these in the show notes, is I've created a second tab, which is the teacher key. Now, I haven't told anything about it, but I at least put the years in here, and you can see the Stamp Act was 1765, followed by 1767. What I did when I made the student view is I put the events out of order. So they're in the wrong order here, and as part of the researching process, they have to go in and find out what year that happened. Why? Because if you have the year in its own column, we can use the sorting feature in Google Sheets to sort the sheet either from the thing that happened most recently to the thing that happened the longest ago, or vice versa, to sort it from the thing that happened the furthest back in time to the one that happened most recently. So you can build into your lesson some critical skills that students would need to use in spreadsheets down the line. How do I sort items and put them in the order that I want if they're all mixed up? For that reason, I've gone in and mixed these items up. And if I put in a different order, let's say I'm just going to arbitrarily do this right now with incorrect dates, just for the example, I can put a number or a date associated with each of these and go in using the sorting feature up above and say sort sheet A to Z, and now it's put them in the order that I feel is correct. Now, a thing to note, of course, when we give this assignment to students, I won't have the key attached to it. I made this so you guys have an idea of how to put this together. Students would only get a copy of this student sheet. But they have to not only identify the year that something happened and write some research or some findings about it, but they need to use that sorting feature in the spreadsheet to put it in the correct order before they submit it to you. Hopefully that makes some sense. I've got another example that I wanted to share here. This one's not necessarily a timeline. It's based on a text and that I found that deals with drawing things in two-point perspective. So this is more of an arts type of approach to it. But I use that exact same spreadsheet, and this one again has a student and a key version, and I put the main steps that we'd find in making a two-point perspective drawing. and I've listed them here. They're straight from the article. What this is really helping you determine is, have students read what you've asked them to read, and did they comprehend it? And on top of that, can they order things that go in a sequence or on a timeline correctly? So you're checking off all these different skills that kids might have by using this simple spreadsheet type activity. So they would go in here and they would make those, in this case, instead of putting a date, they would just give it a 1, 2, 3, or 4, what's the step or the order. But I have a key here, and we would know that you make the horizontal lines and vanishing points. And this is all, again, directly from the reading material that you would provide in your Google Classroom, or that you might have in a textbook or some other related course material that you already have. So these particular spreadsheets are highly adaptable. Choose your content area, choose your grade level, choose what it is you have want students to do, but basically have them learn to sort and order those. When they're done and they have everything sorted correctly, then you bring them back to a site like Sutori and you say, all right, we're gonna make our own timeline with those events. And if I go back, I think, to my main page, it's simple. I gotta go to my stories page, I'm sorry. It's simple to add a new story. I would click create story. I'm gonna give it all the normal things. I'm gonna have to give it a name. I'm gonna have to give it a title. I'm gonna start with a template. But here we go. So if this was the American Revolution, the kids would, revolution, kids would give it that title. They would maybe introduce it, and then their timeline starts here. It's a really simple process where they drag this little button or this little plus, and when you're ready to put something on, you click on it, and then it says, what do you want to insert? A heading, which is what I used for my years, so 1970, 1980. Text or an image or a video. There's a lot of different options. So what I've been doing is adding text, and I said the first step, let's say, in creating that 2D drawing is right here. So once I've completed my spreadsheet, I can go in here and copy that and paste it right into there, and I can put it on my spreadsheet. If I want to add media, I can certainly do this, and you can see that Sutori has some free options and allows you to do quite a few things. I can drag something from my desktop. I can use their own photo library. These are free to use. They're kind of limited, but there's pictures that coincide. You can drag and drop things in. You could link a source, or you could pull in a YouTube video. And that's what I did on a lot of mine on the OG intro. I pulled in those YouTube videos using the share links. So there's a lot of options and a lot of ways to customize this particular tool. And I see that I just made it about American Revolution and then put the drawing in. So sorry for confusing you, but we'll change that to the Stamp Act because I can't have it be incorrect. I've got to fix it before we go here. I think you get the point. There's a WYSIWYG editor in here. There's a lot of features. So as you're thinking about designing lessons, especially lessons that kids do online, think about structuring them with a graphic organizer first, and helping them understand exactly what it is they're supposed to complete or what they're supposed to get from their reading. And then take that when they're done, turn it into you so you can assess it, you can see where they're at and see if they need help. And then make something from it to show what they know. And they make their own Sutori timeline, excuse me. I found another timelining tool that I kind of liked. It was called Time Toast, and the link to that will be in the show notes, so I'll share that with you. Sutori is my preference, but Time Toast is another option. It's all out there. Once you have your idea put together, though, it's really simple to add this kind of stuff into Google Classroom. You can go to your classwork tab. You can create a topic and add to it, if you have an existing topic, excuse me, you can add to it. You can create a topic and add assignments to it. You can upload material to it. So this particular spreadsheet would be material that I would want to put in my assignment. So if I go into math and I click on math, I want to maybe add something. No lessons yet. I got to create assignments and tasks in here. so I'd create an assignment. Or I'd add material. Let's just add, for example, the American Revolution spreadsheet. And you can see I could create in my Google Docs right for there, or since I already have it, I can go straight into my Drive. navigate to where I have that particular document stored, which is in my EDU 218 in this case. You all right, Aiden?
No, I was just eating a brownie.
Were you eating a brownie? Mm-hmm. How was it?
It was real good. Put a sign up that said I'm using the restroom.
Are you? So here's my timeline.
What?
And I'm going to add that. Took me a minute to get there, but there's my American Revolution. So I can add that. I can put my directions here as well. Are you about ready for your segment? Because I just explained how you might use Sutori and Google Sheets for timelines and sequencing. I'm ready. But I think it's probably time to move on. Time to go to Aiden's classroom.